Talk about doing the tool tour though. How did that, I mean, how was that? That's probably fucking next level, life changing, like with, as far as the crowd size and, you know, all the fans and stuff like that and dealing with that.
Yeah, I mean, I think that as an experience, it's everything that, you know, you guys are picturing, because you guys have all played shows and probably even like bigger festivals than me. So you know what it's like to play like a crowd that big, but there is just something different about like a three band, no, a two band bill, but it's at the Mandalay Bay Sport Arena, you know, or something. Like it's a trip. So everything from like the nerves, you know, like there was absolutely like a new sense of nerves that had not been there in like a zillion years, to like the technology. I mean, this was 2012. And even then, you know, I still would describe us as being a pretty like scrappy little outfit with not the most professional of gear in our touring rig, if you know what I mean. So here we are, like raw dogging it on like shitty bar fucking monitors every night and stuff. And right from the first night, like Tool's crew, who they had zero like obligation to be nice or cool to us. I've toured with smaller bands than Tool where their crew was kind of like trying to big dick us or something. And no, Tool's crew were super cool.
Fuck yeah.
They like just they saw us like dicking around with our shitty stuff on day one, and they were just like, hey, like how about you use these in-ear packs that we have all lined up? There's like 60 of them right here. We'll just put your names on them in tape and you can use them for the whole tour. How's that? And we're like,
Jesus.
oh, okay. But we're like, oh, but like we don't know anything about, and they're like, no, don't worry about it. We'll just do it. Boom. Can you hear? Can, oh yeah, oh you're good. Like they just did it for us. They just like laced
Yeah.
us up, you know?
Jesus.
So that was super cool. Oh, and one topic that I thought of that we could talk about in this podcast is tour pranks, which Intronaut is actually legendary for.
I want to hear him.
But I think we all know that there's kind of like a, you know, an imbalance of power on a tour, that when it comes to pranking bands, that you usually prank down, not up. You don't prank the headliners, right? Like
You can
they.
prank, like, if they're like a little bit up, you can prank up, but not like
Yeah.
tool up.
Or if you're like super bros or something, you know,
Totally.
but the general the base setting is
Yeah.
I know, you know. But we no, we did not prank Tool, but they pranked us by coming out on stage. Justin was wearing a full ghillie suit, like the mossy fucking camouflage thing, you know, and skis. And he just came like clomping out onto the stage.
While you guys are playing.
Yeah, like between songs or something. And he comes out and we're all laughing, like, what the fuck, you know? And then Danny Carey, who's like 6'6" or something, I mean, he's just like a man mountain, comes out shirtless in overalls with a big straw hat and no shoes, and chases Justin off the stage before we can like.
I would say after that, you guys should have got him back, dude.
No, I mean it's Tool though. You're just thankful that happened.
In fact, even if I wanted to prank Tool back somehow, there was a night on that tour where a friend of mine and I tried to watch from side stage. We tried to just go to the side stage to watch Tool, and we got just like spirited off the stage by like
Oh, fuck.
Maynard's jiu-jitsu team, you know, like his security is next level.
Yeah.
Tour pranks should be, they should actually be funny. They should be like clever or original or something. And it also should be like good natured. A couple of my favorites from over the years, I'm just going to run down a couple of my top pranks here. We toured with Def Heaven, but they've got a whole spooky vibe. So on the last night of the tour, we stopped at Walmart. We bought sheets and chains, and we drew ghost mouths and cut eyes. And we came out on stage like rattling the chains to like haunt them during their set, you know? On that same tour, we pranked, and this time we actually pranked up. We pranked the headliner. But it was between The Buried and Me. And we replaced Blake's drumsticks with freshly baked churros. We,
nice, dude.
We like sourced out a fucking churro spot on the way into town. And we had a whole stick bag full of churros that we swapped his stick bag with and left two churros on the snare drum. And then right when they came out, he sat down and we had like a camera and he did like a fill with the churros and took a bite. And we all had a laugh and we're like, okay, here's your sticks. And that was it, you know? But we also actually switched Tommy's microphone with a Fleshlight butthole. And I don't think he thought it was funny.